In the ancient Hebrew scriptures, there's a story about a young man and three friends who were presented with the option of either eating what was put before them on the king's table or going another way. Going another way could have cost them their lives. But did they do the right thing? Stick around and find out. Hey folks, this is Dr. Davis with you. I want to talk to you about the story of Daniel and his three friends, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. Now, these four young men were captured during the sacking of Jerusalem by King Nebuchadnezzar. You can actually go and look in your history books and you can see when this took place. But suffice it to say, we're going to keep this kind of at a Sunday school level, if you will. But what I really want to do is explore something here that often gets misconstrued by very fundamental Christians when it comes to diet, but especially amongst Seventh-day Adventists. So what am I doing? For those of you who don't even have a religious bone in your body, I'm empowering you. I'm giving you tools in your arsenal so that when you have conversations with these particular folk about a proper human diet, you will be ready to give the correct answer. So in this story, these four young Hebrews were presented with anything and everything that would go contrary to the Mosaic law given in Leviticus 11 when it came to the type of foods that should be eaten. And so Daniel was able to make a deal, if you will, with the captain of the guard. And he said, look, here's the deal. Try us. For 10 days, let us just eat pulse and drink water. That's all we want to do. And after those 10 days, if you find that we are sickly or not in the kind of shape that you would expect us to be, then very well, we'll eat whatever's put on the table. Now, you will remember in a few videos past, I talked about this idea of clean versus unclean animals. Well, this is what is happening here with Daniel and his friends. But the real question is this. The 10-day trial of eating only vegetables and water and drinking water, is that something that is a good prescription for long-term health? I don't think so. And let me tell you why. Because it has been shown that short periods of fasting using pulse, that is vegetables, legumes, beans, and so forth, can actually bring the body to a state where it will actually repair itself over time. But there are some suppositions here. And one of those suppositions is that these grains are sprouted, or excuse me, these beans, these legumes are sprouted such that the maximum nutrition can be extracted from the plant. Moreover, many of the oxalates and harmful lectins that are contained therein are actually diminished. To what degree? I don't know. This was several thousand years ago. Furthermore, raw vegetables or lightly steamed, we don't know how they were prepared, can actually have a beneficial effect. Now, I am not saying go out and eat all this stuff. What I'm trying to show you here is very simple, that Daniel and his friends, after this 10-day trial was over, they did not stick to this diet. Well, how do we know that? Because a little bit later in the book, chapter 10 to be exact, Daniel is offering up a prayer. And in that prayer, he is committing himself to a three-week fast. And in that three-week fast, he only drank water, and he drank no wine, and he ate no flesh. So what does that tell you? Is that at some point they went back to a proper human diet in accordance with the book of Leviticus. Now let me tell you what I think happened just based upon a simple reading of the text. And mind you, there is some derivation that's going on here. The sole purpose of the 10-day trial, when afterwards they were quote-unquote fatter in flesh and much healthier than the ones that had eaten all the things that we probably shouldn't eat. We don't know what kind of delicacies were on the table. We probably just can imagine they were delicacies of affluence. But here's what I think happened. Just because of the continuity that we see in this particular ancient scripture. And that is this. Daniel and his friends convinced the Babylonian guard that they were to be trusted and that they were going to be loyal subjects of the king. Yes, they were captives. Yes, they had been castrated and made eunuchs. Nevertheless, this was the lot in which they found themselves. But he and his friends, Daniel and his friends, had earned the confidence of the captain of the guard. What do I think happened afterward? That the captain of the guard gave favor to Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, and permitted them to have a diet in keeping with the God whom they served, because it was said that anyone who would speak contrary to the God of Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah would actually fall under the condemnation of the king. So what's the end of the story? The end of the story is, contrary to what some fundamentalist Christians, further Seventh-day Adventists might think, Daniel and his friends did not do a lifelong vegetarian, moreover a vegan diet. They did something very short-term in a fasting type of manner so that they could prove to their captives that they could be trusted, and then revert, if you will, to a proper human diet. And for them, that meant in keeping with the book of Leviticus and the diet that was set forth by God in the ancient scriptures. You know, I understand some of you might not give a hoot about this in terms of your own personal convictions, and that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm only doing this so that you might be empowered, like I said at the beginning, to deal with people who might give this contrary view. And so really what I'd like to know that now is, tell me what you think. You know, what are your thoughts on this matter? Does it really matter what we eat, how we eat, when we eat, things along those lines? And, you know, what I'd really be interested in is, what kind of interactions have you had with people who have gone contrary to you embracing a proper human diet? That is, one that is animal-centric and plant kingdom very diminished, if at all. I'd like to know those. And so, friends, until next time, this is Dr. Alan Davis wishing you above all things that you might prosper, be in health, and have abundant life. Take care.